At least everyone will say you're cute, yeah.
G'day, Paul.
How's it going, Michael?
So, I've asked you the first question, what's your name? So, where are you from?
We're originally from Bynalong, our most immediate address.
Where's that?
It was halfway between Yass and Harden.
Okay.
And it's actually part of the inland route that Hume and Hobble took on their second track, coming down, opening up the route from Sydney to Melbourne, the commercial route from Sydney to Melbourne.
Okay.
So it's one of the oldest colonial settlements in Australia outside of Sydney or Melbourne. Come and join me. This is my wife, Sue.
Oh, get in.
Come on, come and join us.
Kick the flag out of his face.
Come on.
That's better. Going to use
our
Costco card.
Oh, right.
Now can I...
Sorry, brother.
So why are you here in Canberra? What's brought you up here?
All right, so that's a series of events that began in 2020, obviously, with the whole COVID shit show. My wife started a small independent pasta business. We worked it as a sole trader, just as a duo team. Occasionally, we got an odd person in to help us. But, yeah, long story short, we supplied high-quality food to... the Capital Regional Farmers Market and also our Southside Farmers Market, a few other people. Actually, we had a reasonable network at one stage because there was a wholesaler that was distributing our stuff as well, blah, blah, blah. But we never had a retail situation as such. We were always sort of...
We're a boutique.
We're high-end, small batch product.
Right?
So anyway, all
of
that...
I just got to stay close. You've got to get your head down here because the microphone only reaches to here.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, so, great.
So... As a result of the mask mandates that came in ACT, I think it was August of last year, I refused to wear a mask and I was singled out and made an example of.
Well, can I ask, why did you refuse to wear a mask?
Because by that time I understood that the masks are actually detrimental to my health and also that they were a form of... psychological control and manipulation, that the people who were wearing them were actually showing their compliance with the system rather than thinking for themselves, right? Because the science actually says if you're rebreathing your own bacteria, man, for more than 20 minutes, guess what happens?
Yeah,
I mean, even the police we spoke to yesterday, all of those people understood. I spoke to them, like all the fit guys, they're like, fuck, we hate wearing this shit, man.
Yeah.
You know, because they know what it's doing to their body, right?
Yeah.
They want to keep themselves at peak position. They know that if shit goes sideways, they're not going to be at peak physical condition if they've been standing there with a fucking mask all day.
Yeah,
right?
Totally
it's
here.
As simple as that. Yeah, so
totally
I'm
here.
Sorry, I'm getting too wild. But, yeah.
No, that's what we're here
for.
Yeah,
right. That's why I refuse to wear a mask. And because I actually read the ACT health directives and there was provision there for me not to wear a mask, right? So that's where I stood, and I stood within their corporate law, I still had the right not to be there and operate without a mask, right?
Yeah.
Because that actually included that, obviously, because they don't want to discriminate, because that's also part of their corporate law system, right?
Yeah.
So anyway, I mean, the corporation law, not corporate law, the corporation law system. So anyway, that's where I stood. The police were called. Up to that point, there was no drama. Like, my regular customers don't have a problem with it. You know, we didn't lose business because I wasn't wearing a mask, right? You know, people actually, I think, were happy that there was someone who was, you know, at least standing up for what they believed anyway. So the police were called. The management informed me they were coming. I said, that's fine, I'm quite happy to talk to them. They came. They shoved a mask in my face and said, you have to put this on. I said, no, I don't. Back and forth it went. Long story short, they couldn't force me to put a mask on. They didn't find me. They changed their tact and they said, well, we've actually been informed or instructed by the management
Rotary.
At Capital Regional Farmers Market, the Rotary Club of Hall. They have instructed us that it is their policy that all stallholders wear a mask. And if you don't mask up, you have to pack your stall up now, otherwise we will arrest you for trespass. Now, I didn't know my law on that, so I complied at that point. I said, all right, I'll pack up my stall, but I'm not putting on a mask. And if that's Rotary's policy, mate, that really stinks, right? Because they never made me aware of that. Up to that point, I'd already informed the Rotary manager that I was not going to wear a mask. And she said, oh, well, should I put you down for a mask exemption then? And I said, yeah, sure. So they were already aware of my position, and they never said to me, no, Paul, you have to wear a mask, right? Because that's our official position. I wasn't told that by them. I was told that by the fucking cops, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so long story short, they actually expelled us from the market over the incident, right? That was on the Saturday. By the Wednesday, we received an email saying don't come back because of this incident. So that's our livelihood gone, basically.
Wow.
Sold the house.
And as a result,
business is gone. We had to sell the house.
I'm just going to start again with that. Just the camera, the